Thanks, Hank. Well, we're talking soy sauce today. It's a great addition to many dishes, but it can immediately add thousands of milligrams of sodium. So in today's Love It Like It, Hate It picks, Molly Kimball gives us her best and worst ideas when it comes to soy sauce. And some of these are kind of soy sauce-esque.
Right, soy sauce-esque. And so try them. And just like anything, if you taste it the first time, you're like, ooh, that's not what I was used to. Try it again, and a lot of times our taste buds can kind of acclimate to it.
Okay.
But there are options, and here's the thing, that our hate it category in this, you know, I always say I love it when we have a lot of love it options.
Yeah.
Slim pickings here.
Aww.
Yeah, and okay. Our hate it is just pretty broad. And so even when you're looking at low sodium soy sauce, per tablespoon, you're often looking at 500, almost 600 milligrams of sodium in a single tablespoon.
Yeah.
And when we look at the things that we dip in soy sauce and how fast that little dish can go away,
and we keep
pouring more in there, so we can easily use 2, 3, 4 tablespoons.
Okay.
The other thing I'd say is when you're comparing labels, some products will give you the nutrition facts for a tablespoon,
mm-hmm.
others for a teaspoon.
Oh my gosh.
So kind of,
who uses a teaspoon? I mean, that's nothing.
Who uses a teaspoon? Yeah. And then also when you're looking at that product, though, it looks like it's going to be really great, but you've actually got to times three.
Yeah.
Exactly, do the math.
Okay.
So what we've got in our Love It, these are from more natural food type places. I actually got both of these from Whole Foods. The first one is called coconut aminos.
Okay.
So it's going to be a lot less salty than what we're used to. The nutrition facts here say per teaspoon 90 milligrams, so that looks really good compared to the 900 or so
mm-hmm.
that you'll see on other labels, but that's just for a teaspoon. So when we do the math, adjust for a tablespoon, it's about 270 milligrams of sodium for a tablespoon. Still not bad, but it still can get up there.
Yeah.
So if someone needs a very low sodium diet, we've just got to be sparing even with this.
Okay.
One thing, you know, I always say though, is not everybody needs to watch their salt.
Yeah.
If you're an athlete, you're losing a lot of sweat, you work outside in the heat, this can actually
if
be a good addition.
If it's summer in New Orleans, you
yes.
might want the extra salt.
Exactly.
Because you'll be sweating it out. Okay.
The one I've got next to this is a brand we know about, the Bragg's apple cider vinegar.
Mm-hmm.
This is their liquid aminos, and we actually have it in another category coming up, but what's different about this one is that it's the spray.
Ah.
And so the fact that it's the spray, it gives us such a small amount, it basically, for a half of a teaspoon, which is considered a serving, there's about 72 servings in this bottle,
mm-hmm.
there's 160 milligrams of sodium. Now, when you correct that for a tablespoon, we're still looking at 960 milligrams of sodium per tablespoon. The key here, though, is the spray.
Okay, got
so
it.
So sometimes with any sprays, people open up that bottle and they pour it. They
yeah,
just,
don't
you know,
do that.
Right, they're not patient. Don't do that. Key is the spray, is the portion control.
Okay, and I tried that last time you brought it in, and it's good.
I liked it.
I thought the flavor was good. It's a little different, but I liked it.
You've got to be patient with it, though, you know, because again, you're spraying. It's not that much. You're getting just that little bit of flavor. You're really, the end result there is you're actually tasting the food.
Yeah.
And that soy sauce type flavor is an accent. What I've got in our Like It, this is the Sanjay Tamari. And the difference with tamari and soy sauce, so soy sauce is typically made with soy and wheat. Tamari is usually made with either little or no wheat.
Hmm.
So if you're looking for a gluten-free option, tamari is usually going to be your better bet.
Okay.
Always check the labels, though, of course. So this tamari light for a tablespoon, we're looking at 490 milligrams of sodium.
Mm.
That's still a lot. And I haven't given the reference point. When someone needs a low-sodium diet, 1,500 milligrams.
For the whole day.
For the whole day.
Oh,
so a tablespoon of this, given us just under 500,
yeah.
that still creeps up a lot.
Okay.
And then our hate it, I think these are no surprises.
Yeah.
You know, so these are a lot of the guys that we usually see. Our regular soy sauce with the red cap at the end, we've got our low sodium soy sauce. The regular soy sauce, as much as 980 milligrams of sodium in a tablespoon. What I'd like to point out, though, is the Bragg's liquid aminos that I said, we're still looking at 960 milligrams.
Yeah.
So you may say, oh, I'm trying to do better. I'm going to switch to that Bragg's liquid aminos. It's really still just as high.
Okay.
And again, even a lot of these less sodium or less salt soy sauces, 520, 570. So just that label's not going to be the answer. We've often got to be a little bit more sparing with how much we use.
Okay, we're out of time. Real quick though, what's coming up in our next segment?
So coming up next, I'm all about soy sauce right now, probiotics. So when we're looking at soy sauce is our fermented products here.
Okay.
And so we've got some new, and some of them new to us here in New Orleans, products on shelves are gonna help us get more probiotics into our diets.
All right, sounds good. Thanks, Molly, and we'll be right back here on Good Morning New Orleans.